Today I am going to tell you how to derive EMF equation using connection diagram. So first of all, already before connection diagram, you all must know that already you must have studied. By construction also we can derive EMF equation, that is 5Z MV by 16. Now we are going to derive using connection diagram. How? And before going for this connection diagram, one should know how to draw the armature winding and field winding. So armature winding is a rotating part, so we draw a cylinder, and inside, since it is a generator, this is a G, and since it is a DC generator, so DC straight line. Since it is armature winding, A1 A2 then. The next winding is field winding, this is stationary winding, so simple winding design, and it has F1 and F2. That's all. So by using this, we are going to find our connection diagram. So now we are going to see the series DC generator. So in series generator, armature winding, field winding, both are going to be connected in series. So this is a field winding, this is armature winding, and now these two are connected in series. Then now it is a generator. Generator wants mechanical energy, so we are going to rotate this armature. So here mechanical input. Now I am rotating the generator. Armature is rotating. Now already this is a field winding. This field winding is already producing the flux, magnetic field. Now this armature is rotating in the magnetic field. It cuts the magnetic field. Now in this armature, the EMF is generated. Now this generated EMF is called source. It is a battery. Now let I draw this EMF like this. Because it is a battery, it is a source. Source is generated now. Now from this battery, current will flow. Because it is a battery, it will supply current. Current will flow from armature to the field and it will come out. Once it comes out, then we take it as a output voltage, that is called terminal voltage. Now, when the current flows, where it is flowing? From the armature, from this battery. Where? First it will go to the armature. This armature has a resistance, internal resistance, that is RE, so RE. And the same current flows to the field also. So, that same current is flowing in the field resistance also, RF. Then, that same current, so here we can say it is a current, and that current goes to RE, that current goes to RF. Now you get a output VD. So this is the equivalent circuit diagram. Now from this EG, when the current flows through this RA, it makes a drop. So that is IRA drop. Same current when flows here, it makes a drop, IRF drop. So now we want to find out, you can find out either EG or you can find out either PT. How? By using KVL. How? What is KVL? Source of algebraic sum of input voltage equal to drop voltage. What is your input? See this. This is minus plus. This is plus minus, plus minus. This is plus minus, and this is also plus minus. So this will be in one side, remaining on the other side. So this is EMF which is generated is equal to I into RA plus I into RF plus output voltage PT. Now, since this current, this is and this one, both are same, since it is flowing in a series connection, so EG will be equal to I is common, R, armature resistance plus RF plus VD. So, this is the final equation of DC series generator. If you want to consider the brush drop, see, whenever we draw the armature winding, we draw this two square box. What is that? It is a brush. Brush means either it is a generator or it is a motor. We give supply or we take the supply through the brushes. So sometimes they always write BD drop, brush drop. Okay? So that brush drop also can be added at the end if it is given in the numerical. Okay? The same thing, if you want to consider for the shunt winding, same, just you remove the field winding and this field winding will be connected in parallel. See this? So this is a field winding, F1 and F2. Same process.